My dear colleagues, good afternoon. Arise interview. President Buhari is evasive, dodgy, claimed the projects of the People's Democratic Party. The People's Democratic Party is appalled by President Muhammadu Buhari's deplorable performance at the exclusive interview on Arise television this morning. Our party is dismayed that while millions of Nigerians eagerly expected President Buhari to use the interview to address salient issues confronting our nation, Mr. President bungled the opportunity by being evasive and dodgy while attempting to lay claims to projects done by the People's Democratic Party administrations. Instead of addressing issues and providing direction for our nation, Mr. President exposed his cluelessness, paucity of idea for development, while making very provocative statements that could embolden terrorists as well as serve as recipe for further division and violence in our country. On infrastructure, it is ludicrous to us in the People's Democratic Party that Mr. President can disingenuously seek to subtract the deliverables achieved by past PDP administration from the so-called achievement on infrastructure. The PDP places on record, and we know that Nigerians are also aware that President Olusegun Obasanjo, who was elected on the platform of the People's Democratic Party, introduced a 25-year national development plan upon assumption of office in 1999. This included a massive construction and expansion of road network, power plants, railway projects, inland and coastal waterways, airports, housing, agricultural and health projects, as well as establishment of new universities and various other legacy projects in various parts of our country. We want to inform President Buhari, since he's not always aware, that successive governments elected on the platform of the People's Democratic Party build on these development plans, leading to the expansion of major trunk roads across our country, railways, and other legacy projects, which probably his handlers are making him to believe that he was responsible for such projects. It is on record that President Goodluck Jonathan also took on a massive expansion of our international and domestic airports across the country, built and commissioned railway stations, just like former President Yar'Adua also embarked on road projects, particularly from Abuja. It is instructive to state that where projects were yet to be completed, it is only a natural occurrence for any Nigerian elected as president to proceed in the national interest to complete such projects. And we have nothing against that. The PDP therefore considers it tacky for Mr. President to seek to claim every credit for projects he never conceptualized, commenced, or built to near completion, just because he found himself in the office at the point of completion. Should Mr. President be reminded that even the expansion of the presidential villa, including the banquet hall, which his party, the All Progressives Congress, used today as their national secretariat, was conceptualized and built by the PDP government, even though leaders of the APC stood stoutly against the project while it was ongoing. President Buhari also needs to accept the bitter fact that the current drawback in infrastructural development in our country started with his administration. Like a relay race, successive PDP administrations further infrastructural development only for him to run the opposite direction when the baton was passed to him. It is important to state that only the ongoing refurbishing of Akwanga Maiduguri Road that President Buhari can lay claim to as the singular and only project in which he has demonstrated capacity. The expectation of Nigerians is that in an interview like this, Mr. President should give honor to those who conceptualized and built these projects to near completion. And in most cases, only for him to perform the commissioning ceremony. Mr. President must also be reminded that all institutions of good governance under the contemporary dispensation, including the Economic and Financial Crime Commission, the ICPC, the Asset Management Company of Nigeria, the Debt Management Office, among others, were PDP's creation. Even the Sovereign Wealth Fund, which has become the referral point for his administration, was created by the PDP with stiff opposition from leaders of the APC, like former governors Rotimi Amaechi and Adams Oshiomhole. On the issue of devolution of power, state police, and restructuring, it is disappointing and heart-rending that Mr. President was evasive, he was dodgy, and had no direct response to these burning issues, even in the face of a national consensus for the amendment of the 1999 Constitution to address these pertinent issues. It is also alarming that Mr. President, in his own words, dismissed two governors who ran to him for solution to issues of national security, with escalated killings, kidnapping, and violence in their states. The action, as revealed by Mr. President, is very disturbing because, as the commander-in-chief, on whose shoulder rests the responsibility of securing our nation, and who also promised to lead from the front, his reaction ought not to have been dismissive of the said governors. This action, as narrated by Mr. President, clearly showed how he abdicated responsibility and yet was audacious to come to the public arena and made open his personal flaws and failures that have affected the foundation of our national security and emboldened terrorists, kidnappers, and bandits to attack and kill our compatriots. On the issue of fuel subsidy, it is a known fact that cross-border crimes like smuggling have their negative effect on prices of petroleum products. While this constitutes a challenge to our economy, the fundamental issue which Mr. President dodged in that interview is the sleazy nature of subsidy policy under his administration. Mr. President failed to tell Nigerians how the volume of PMS fuel used in our country progressed exponentially from 35 million liters per day to the current fictitious 100 million liters per day, upon which his administration subsidy payout is calculated. In an interview, in which for the first time in the history of his administration, President Buhari flamboyantly faced the camera, the opaque nature of the subsidy regime under his administration ought to have been topical. The expectation of Nigerians was for Mr. President to speak about the openness of his administration's subsidy regime, as well as why Nigerians are paying humongous sums on subsidy. On corruption, we invite Nigerians to note that President Buhari admitted in the interview that corruption was endemic in his administration, that there are corrupt persons in his government and his party, but that he devised a way of easing them out and thus giving them official cover instead of exposing such persons and allowing them to face the law. This validates the position of the People's Democratic Party, that the Buhari administration is a sanctuary of corruption. It is also distressing that President Buhari used the interview to issue threats to Nigerians, as well as justify the nepotism that has characterized the appointment of key officials of his administration to the charging of our national sensibilities. Such disposition to our national sensibilities is a recipe for further divisions and violence in our country. Most disheartening is that, in the face of grave security concerns across the Federation, President Buhari proffered no solutions, even when he admitted that insecurity had almost overwhelmed his administration. Also, though he lamented the invasion of our national territory by Sahelians, Mr. President did not introduce any concrete measure that can vanquish this set of criminals. The interview session was therefore a presidential demonstration of the challenges confronting our nation without a modicum of solution, either now or in the future. It was all about bulk passing, grandstanding, and a holier than thou disposition of the Buhari presidency. From the interview, it is clear that President Buhari has no legacy project to point to except infrastructural backwardness, false performance claims, covering of corruption, destroying of our national institutions, wrecking of our economy, dividing Nigerians, as well as reckless borrowing without, with nothing to show for it. Thank you very much. Any questions?